Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. Like it or not, but our habits create our lives and who we are. Bad habits like spending money can put us in a debt and add stress to our lives. Good habits, however, can improve the quality of our lives and help us to achieve things that we want. Habits like running in the mornings will increase your energy and keep you fit. Creating healthy habits is challenging unless you know the right strategies that you can put in practice. Today, we'll take a look at the James Clear book called Atomic Habits to learn the easy and proven way to build new habits and break old ones. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. Also, check out my free productivity resources that has helped thousands of people to set better goals, make better decisions, and build solid structure in their life. Every time I think about habits, I remember the quote from Brian Tracy: "Bad habits are easy to develop, but hard to live with. Good habits are hard to develop, but easy to live with." It's easy to order fast food, but such habit affects our health as well as increases our expenses. On the other hand, developing a writing habit takes more effort, but the benefits in the long run are well worth it. So let's take a look at the best takeaways from Atomic Habits to understand how habits are formed and what strategies we can use to build lasting habits. Number 1, the cumulative effect. The first thing that author emphasizes is the fact that little habits have huge power to change our life. But people often underestimate little habits because of no immediate impact that we can see. If you are out of shape today and you go for a run, then you'll be still out of shape tomorrow. Or you might study for 2 hours and still be unclear about understanding the concept that you're trying to learn. But despite the fact that you can't see the progress, you're still moving towards achieving your goal. If you keep running for 6 months, then your physical conditioning will improve, and it's likely that you'll lose some weight as well. Little changes are adding up, and eventually they deliver massive results. Just remember that this is how bad habits can creep up to you as well. If you start eating unhealthy, then you might not notice the change, sometimes for months. But once you have created it as a habit, it will be hard for you to change it. Number 2, understanding habit loop. The habit loop consists of 3 elements. There is a cue, routine, and reward. These 3 elements are consistent for all the habits. The habit loop is a framework for understanding how habits work, and it's up to you to identify each component to modify existing habits or replace them with new ones. If you have a bad habit of wasting time on social media, then you'll know that your habit follows this process. First, there is a cue. This might be a notification that makes you check out your phone. Once you pick up the phone and read the message, you feel the temptation to get some dopamine. So you perform a routine of checking out Facebook and watching some videos. This will give you desired reward, a little dose of dopamine. Number 3, change your environment. One of the best ways to create a good habit is to change your environment and create powerful triggers for your new habits. This was greatly executed in the experiment when the hospital wanted to improve patients' dietary habits without them having to make a conscious decision. To pull this off, hospital cafeteria was rearranged in a way that supported it. Before, there was soda next to the cash registers, and that made it convenient for people to pick it up. After changes, only water was available near the cash registers. Over the 3 months, soda sales dropped by 11%, while water sales increased by a whopping 25%. This just goes to show that we can adjust our environment in a way that it makes the positive cues more obvious, and we will be more likely to adopt our new healthy habits. If you want to read more, then leave the book on your bed. This will be a trigger to pick it up and read a few pages before sleep. Number 4, implementation intentions. Many people want to start healthy habits, but they are really broad with them, and that is a sure path to the failure in adopting new habits. You can't just be willing to exercise more or read more books. You have to be intentional and detailed about how you will do that. Don't just say that you want to read more. Instead, you can say that you'll make it a part of your evening routine. This way, you attach it to your existing habits, making yourself more likely to succeed. Don't just wish for exercising more. Allocate time in your weekly schedule every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday to go for a 3-kilometer run before your work. Number 5, make your habits attractive. We are driven by anticipation of reward, and one of the ways how you can achieve the results that you want is by temptation bundling. Temptation bundling means combining two activities together, one activity that you tend to procrastinate on and other activity that you really enjoy. For example, you might want to develop a habit to exercise, but you can't seem to get started. In this case, you can bundle it up with something that you enjoy, like watching a movie. So you go to the gym, hop onto the bicycle, and put on the movie. The next thing you know, you have done a great 30-minute exercise, as well as watched part of your movie. Number 6, make your habits easy to adopt. Another great strategy when it comes to developing habits is to make them as easy as possible. Here are two strategies to get you started. First, reduce friction. You have to make it as easy as possible to do your new habit. For example, you might be learning a new language with an app called Duolingo. In this case, you can keep this app on your main screen, so every time you pick up your phone, you see the icon and you're tempted to learn a few words. Second, apply 2-minute rule. The way this strategy works is that you have to make your new habit doable in 2 minutes or less. If you want to develop a writing habit, then make your goal to write 2 minutes every day. The goal here is to get you started, as you'll be likely to keep going. Number 7, use habit tracker. Making progress feels great, and that's where the final strategy comes into play, and that is tracking your habits. You can use the Seinfeld method. Get a wall calendar, and every day you do the habit, you mark the day with a big X. After a few days, you will have created a chain, and then your goal is not to break the chain for as long as possible. You can also use one of many habit tracking apps that are available on the App Store to stay on top of the habits that you are building. I hope that you enjoyed this Atomic Habits book summary and you learned some simple strategies to build lasting habits. If you enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you could press the like button, as this will help the video reach more people and spread the message.